गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज के प्रवीण कुमार, मैथमेटिक्स टीचर, काकतीया पब्लिक स्कूल, निजामाबाद। टुडे लेट अस डिस्कस अबाउट एक्सपोनेंट्स एंड पावर, 8th क्लास स्टैंडर्ड। For example, 10 to the power of 9 is there. Here, 10 is called a base and 9 is called power or exponents. Okay? This topic already we have to read in your earlier classes also. Okay? But which purpose we can use exponents powers? That is main important thing. Okay? When will we use exponents and powers? We know directly we not go into laws of powers and exponents. Before going to the topic, so when we use for exponents and powers, which purpose we can use? So that is the important. Directly we should not write 10 to the power of 9. For example, 10 is a base and 9 is a power. We already know that we have to write 10 how many times? What is power here? 9. We have to write 10 in 9 times. We have to multiply 10 in 9 times. Okay? So, my point is, so what is my point here? So, when we will use exponents and powers in our daily life situations, that is important. For example, I will wrote here 4 points. So, first point is, the estimator of the sun is 140000, okay, meters. Next, second one is the mass of earth is 1,98,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000, It is, we cannot write easy, we should not write very easy, and we should not write very, we should not write very hard to read also. Next one, the distance from the sun to earth is 149,600,000 meters. The last one is, the universe is estimated to be about 1,000,000,000,000,000,000 years. We have to observe all these measurements. So it is not a very easy to read and easy to write and easy to understand also. Okay, for example, the mass of Earth is, this is a very huge man. Okay, the mass of Earth, just observe it. The mass of Earth is equal 1,98,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000, this is not to write easy. I mean not to read also easy. I mean now we have to explain to others. It is very difficult to teach. Okay, so these all values are very difficult to read, write, and understand also. Such type of a large value. So that instead of this such a large values, instead of these values, we can use exponential form. In this purpose, we can use power and exponents in our daily life situations. For example, here we have to take the mass of earth is equal, how to write? We have the easy form. You know how to write? This is very easy form. Tell me. So the mass of earth is a very difficult value. Means the value is very very high. So instead of this big value, we have to write very easy form. So how to write easy form? There is one possibility. One possibility is there. What is that possibility? So such a very big value, it is converted into exponential form. Okay, how to write this exponential form? For example, 1 comma 989 comma how many zeros? 1 comma 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12 13 14 15 16 17 18 19 20 23, 26 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26. This is 26, okay? So, in such very big value, we have to convert into exponential form. So, how to write convert into exponential form? 1, 9, 8, 9, 1 multiply with 10 to the power of how many zeros we have to carry here? 1, 2, 3, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26. 26 kilograms. Okay? So, this such type of a huge value, we have to convert it into exponential form. So this is 19,891 into 10 to the power of 26 kilograms. We have to compare to both situations. We have to compare to situation 1 and situation 2. What is the difference between situation 1 and situation 2? Here, situation 1, we cannot use exponential form. So that we cannot to read very easy and we cannot able to write very easy. Okay, here we have to convert it into exponential form. So here we have to write easy. We have to write easy to write and easy to read. Easy to write and easy to read. So how to read such a huge value? 19,891 into 10 to the power of 26 kilogram. So in these situations, we can use exponential and power means exponential and power both are same terms. So in this situation, we can use exponential form. Okay. Another value is there. What is another value is? So the distance from the sun to earth already given in our textbook. So, actually what is the distance from the sun to earth is 149,600,000,000 meters. Okay? This is the distance from the sun to earth already given. Sun to earth, the value 149,600,000,000 meters. This is also a very huge value, you know. This is also, we cannot write very easy and we can't understand very easy. What we do here? So, one best result is there. What is the best method? This value is converted to exponential form. So, how to convert it to exponential form? 1496 into multiply with 10 to the power of how many zeros we have to count? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 meters. So 1496 into 10 to the power of 8 meters. Understood? We have to compare again both situations. Situation 1 and situation 2. Situation 1 is very difficult to write and read. In situation 1. Why? Because here we cannot implementation exponential forms. such a type of a big value, here we have to write in exponential form. Means how to write exponential form is, what is that this huge value, it is converted to exponential form. The value is 1496 into 10 to the power of 8 meters. So what is my conclusion here? So when we can use exponential and power form means such a big values, not only this one, we have to take any other very very big values. We cannot write to very easy to write and it is very difficult to read. In these situations we can use implementation exponential form. If we can use exponential form means we can easy to write and easy to understand. Loss of exponents. Okay, here some more losses there. Okay, loss of exponents. First one, note. So before entering lot of exponents, one important thing is there. So here a comma b are non-zero integers and m comma n is any integer. So we can applicable this loss of exponents. Understood children? So what is note here? So a comma b are non-zero integers. Non-zero integers and m comma n, any integer. Okay, any integers. So here this is the one important note is there. I will explain in further examples. Here what is note here, a comma b are non-zero integers. Okay, and m comma n any integer. You know children, what is integers? Already you have studied in your previous 6th, 7th classes. What is integers here? So what is integer means the set of negative numbers and the set of positive numbers including zero is called integers. You know integers? What is an integer? Integers negative values, positive values along with zero. Okay, negative values means -3, -2, -1, 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. Okay, what is integers? Integers means negative value, positive value including zero, called integer. Okay, here what is my condition is a comma b are non-zero integers and m comma n we have to take any integers. Already we have discussed integers. What is here integers? Negative values, positive values along with zero is called integers. Yes or no? First rule, first law. So a to the power of m into a to the power of n is equal a to the power of m plus n. Okay, here both bases are equal. So what is base here? For example, before entering this one, just briefly about 10 to the power of 9 is there. Yes or no? 10 to the power of 9. Here 10 is called base and 9 is called power and exponent. Understood? Here we have to write 10 how many times? We have to write 10 9 times. Okay? Means we have to multiply with 10 how many times? 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 times. Understood? So, one more example is there. 10 to the power of n is there. How to write 10 to the power? What is here? 10 to the power of n. 10 is a base and n is a power and exponent. We have to write 10 how many times? N times. We have to observe here only power. If we have to, what is the power number? We have to write base or that times. Understood? Here 10 to the power of n means we have to write 10 how many times? 9 times. Means 10 into 10 into 10 into upon into n times. We have to write n times. But we need not write n times. So that 10 into 10 into so on into we have to write 9 times. Here 10 to the power of 9. So how to read 10 to the power of 9? 10 is raised to the power of 9. We have to read as 10 to the power of 9 is 10 is raised to the power of 9. Okay. So let us go with our laws of exponents. First one is a to the power of m into a to the power of n is equal to a to the power of m plus n. Here first law is, here both bases is same. A comma a, both bases is same. If any basis is same, here multiply with the operation into, okay, here both bases are same, what will do? Directly we have add the powers, means here both bases are same, so that we have to write a to the power of, we have to add powers, m plus n. This is the first rule. What is second rule? A to the power of m by a to the power of n, okay. How to write a to the power of m is divided by a to the power of m. So this is right, a to the power of m minus n. Directly we have to division means directly here we have to subtract. So here both bases are equal but powers are different. So that we have to write a to the power of m minus n. Here m is greater than n. We have to fulfill this condition. Okay, next third one, a to the power of m into b to the power of m. Don't confuse children, both are different. Yet both bases are equal but powers are different. In this situation, both bases are different but powers are equal. Okay, here in this situation, both bases are equal but both bases are not equal. Here base is A and in this situation base is B. But power is same. Powers are same. M. So A to the power of M into B to the power of M is equal. We have to multiply with the bases. A into B over the power of M. Means AB to the power of M. This is the rule. Next to go for 4 to the power of M is divided by B to the power of M. Okay, here we have to observe in this rule. Here both bases are different. Here first base is A, here base is B, but powers are same. M powers. How to write this rule? Means A by B over the power of, here common means here M and M common. Directly A by B over the power of M. So A to the power of M is divided by B to the power of M is equal to A by B over the power of M. Next, go for fifth rule. A to the power of minus N is equal to 1 by A to the power of plus N. Or A to the power of N is equal to 1 by A to the power of minus N. Okay? So, we have to write directly reciprocally. So, already reciprocal we have to study in your earlier classes. In 6th standard or 7th standard, okay? So, A to the power of minus n, we have to write A to the power of minus n is equal to 1 by A to the power of n, or A to the power of n is equal to 1 by A to the power of minus n. Again, last rule is this, 6th rule, this is very very important, any number to the power of 0. So, what is the value? Any number, we have to take any A to the power of 0, the value is always 1. Okay? Any number, we have to take any number, the power is 0 means the whole value is equivalent to 0. For example, 21 over the power of 0. 21 is a number, integer. The what is power here? 0. Any number to the power of 0, what is the value? Any number. The power is 0 means the whole value is equivalent to 1 only. So 21 over the power of 0 means 1. For example, 101 over the power of 0. What is the 101 over the power of 0? We need not to see this number. We don't know. We don't bother about that number. We have to observe only power. The power is equivalent to 0 means any big value we don't know. The value is always equivalent to 1. For example, 29432. 29,432 to the power of 0. We don't need not to see this number. But what is power here? The power is 0. Any number we don't know. The power 0 means the whole value is equivalent to 1. Okay, children. So this is the part 1 regarding our topic exponents and powers. Okay. Thank you, students. We will discuss next topics tomorrow. Thank you very much.
You have 3 more questions.